look up anyway, but she is bracing for that moment of totality.
It'll be cool. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Is this your car?
We spotted these folks because of the alien and solar eclipse or bust painted on their car.
It's a natural occurrence. You can't make it happen. You can only wait for it to happen.
For everyone here, in one way or another, it's about family and friends and community. Something so much larger than any of us, or even all of us.
At the core of it, it's an astronomical event. But there's a kind of a sociological side. There's a psychological side. Are you in awe? Are you in wonder? Do you think I'm really small and insignificant? Or does this motivate you to do something more with your life?
For the record, dogs do not need eclipse glasses because we are the only animals stupid or smart enough to be looking up at the sign. But almost everyone who does feel something during totality. And what a lot of people are feeling right now in America is worry about the cloud cover. So let's go to Lonnie Quinn from CBS New York, who's in upstate New York, Wilmington. Lonnie, the hour is almost upon us. Good morning. How's it looking?
Well, you know what? For some people, it's looking great. And for other people, it's not looking good at all. There are folks called Umberphiles who chase totality all over the world, Tony. And they've made reservations a year or more in advance. Well, it comes down to what the weather's going to serve up, because nothing hurts totality more than cloud cover. Let me show you what's going on dynamically, because simply put, you've got a low-pressure system around Texas giving really, really bad volatile weather. You have a high-pressure system off the East Coast giving really, really great weather. So the best weather of all is going to be in northern Maine. Enjoy it. Then you get to Buffalo. Buffalo, your numbers have been going higher and higher and higher, and I'm talking cloud cover percentage. As of right now, it looks like 85% cloud cover. I think you may just be socked in Buffalo. For Indianapolis, where you are, Tony, your number has bumped up a bit. You were running about 20%. Now it's 35%. I think you'll have that milky, sort of high, thin cloud cover. So you'll see some semblance of totality. For Dallas and Austin, it's a tough go there. San Antonio, some of the worst weather of all the way up to places like Little Rock. Real bad. I mean, you've got lots of cloud cover, but look at the severe weather risk. Like I said, Dallas, San Antonio, Little Rock, not just severe, you could have twists in the atmosphere. Tornadoes are a risk out there today. But again, it's all about where the best viewing is. If you can get to Maine, get there right now. We were supposed to be in Rochester, changed our plans, and here we are at Lake Placid. So, guys, let's go back to you. You're not even in the studio today. We're all out somewhere.
No. We're all on an adventure, Lonnie. It looks cold where you are, but it looks gorgeous as well. Thank you very much, and I like that report on Indianapolis. Things are looking better. Texas, meanwhile, is where we're going to go next. That's set to be the first state to experience today's eclipse, and it's where Americans have a shot at the longest period of darkness, more than 4 minutes. But the weather there may not cooperate, as just heard Lonnie mention. Janet Chamlian is in the small city of Kerrville, Texas. That's near San Antonio. Kerrville has been planning for this for years. People have driven in for hours. Janet, good morning. Gosh, how are they feeling? What's the mood there this morning?
Yeah, Tony, good morning to you. There is concern about the weather here, and truth be told, I felt sprinkles a few minutes ago, but the consensus here is stay optimistic. Here in Kerrville, they're asking people to arrive at least 3 hours early by 10 o'clock local time because of the crowds expected here. And let me give you a look at the San Antonio airport over the past couple of days. Boy, the planes have been packed there. We've been seeing people come in, groups, families from all over the country. Kerrville is hosting a festival here. This is one of three places that they are going to be broadcasting live. NASA's broadcasting live. They've got food trucks. They've got music. And, of course, all the small towns in the Texas Hill Country are hoping to take advantage, get a little piece of the tourist pie. Wineries in Fredericksburg are holding viewing parties. And we visited a glass factory where you could actually make an eclipse-inspired paperwork. Wait. So, yeah, everybody's trying to get in on this. And for those concerned about the weather, we did happen to run into our friend Stephanie Abrams from the Weather Channel. She's also broadcasting from this area. She told me she saw an eclipse in 1999. It was completely cloudy until 5 minutes before totality. The clouds parted. She was able to see it perfectly. So there is hope. As for today, in this area, in Texas, Tony, they're asking people to pack their patience because there's just going to be a lot of traffic on the roads.
There is always hope, though. The heavens may cooperate. Janet, thank you very much, even if traffic does not. Speaking of a chance for a break in the clouds, let's go to Cleveland now, because by the time totality hits there around 3:13 Eastern time, to be specific, our Dave Malkoff may be able to see that totality. total solar eclipse. Dave, good morning to you. This is fun for everybody, but scientists in particular, I understand, are also planning a bit of an experiment there. What do you know?
Good morning, Tony. This isn't just a place where you can get a funnel cake and look at the sky. This is what amounts to a huge NASA-sanctioned science experiment right in the heart of Cleveland. I grew up here in what is now called the NASA Glenn Research Center and the Visitor Center. It is now over here. The Visitor Center has moved to the Science Center, and over the weekend, we have all these tents that have come out. It is now a big solar festival with all sorts of experiments out here. NASA is launching high-altitude aircraft with better camera than they had back in 2017. They're also launching three rockets up into the ionosphere so they can see the corona of the sun as the moon crosses over and blocks it out. And that is what we hope to see right here for almost 4 minutes right here in Cleveland, Tony.
Very cool, Dave. Thank you very much. We'll, of course, have live coverage of today's total eclipse beginning at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific right here on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus. But for all that is going on in the sky today, there's also a lot going on back here on Earth where our feet are planted. So for all of